I found a blue cheapie for under $25. Is it a gem or is it a dud? Welcome back to my channel. I'm Jensen. Let's smell. While fragrance shopping at Ross, I came across a fragrance house that I've never tried. I saw two different offerings, but I chose just one to try it out. Yes, another blind buy. The things I do for you guys, right? By the way, don't forget to hit that like button. And if you haven't done so already, subscribe. You don't want to miss any of my upcoming videos. From the French fragrance house, Fashionable Riviera 90 milliliter EDP concentration. Whether you pronounce it Fashionable or Faconable, it really doesn't matter. What does matter is how this smells. So let's get to it. This is a 2021 release. Forget batch codes and presentation. Let's just smell this already. The atomizer is pretty good. The opening has grapefruit, mandarin, and incense. The incense provides a light smoky richness to that citrus mix. No cheap alcohol smell here. It's well blended. For a $25 fragrance, this smells of higher quality. The opening may remind you of Bleu de Chanel and Versace Dylan Blue. They do share some notes in common with the incense and grapefruit. It does have that similar blue vibe. Nutmeg, red apple, and eucalyptus enter the mid, giving it a dash of spice and juicy fruitiness. Guaiac wood, amber, patchouli, and leather balance out the base of the composition. Into the mid and the dry down, it does remind me of two other fragrances, Hugo Boss Orange Man and Baldessarini Ombre. Now these have that apple note plus some leather. It does have aspects of these two, especially the leather and the apple. It smells so good. I don't think this is a clone of Bleu de Chanel or even Dylan Blue. I do see the similarities with that grapefruit and incense note. However, that apple fruitiness and warm, soft leather give this a unique composition. Who is this fragrance for? This is for someone who's on a budget and wants that Bleu de Chanel, Dylan Blue vibe for a fraction of the price. This could work well for evenings. It has a touch of seductiveness. It smells elegant, professional, masculine. It's not heavy, it's not going to project. It is an eau de parfum concentration. You will smell it throughout the day. Duration is average. It's about 4 to 6 hours, depending if you spray lightly or spray heavy. This one you might have to reapply, but it's not a bad thing. It smells really good, it's a cheap price, and it's not too loud or offensive. You could wear this to the office. I see it more as an evening scent. You can wear this out on a date, and it's one of those fragrances where it's not going to project, but it will bring someone close to you because they want to smell you. It does have aspects of being alluring. That leather, incense, sweet apple, warm, amber woodiness all come together and create something very surprisingly good for $25. I do think it has great versatility. You can wear this on most occasions year-round. Any age group can pull this one off. This one may not excite everyone. If you're a niche head, if you have all these blue fragrances, this would probably seem boring or generic or whatever term you want to throw out there. But if you don't have a lot of blue fragrances, if you're looking for something that's not too expensive and will get you close to that Bleu de Chanel, Dylan Blue vibe, then this is for you. If you want something that's alluring, masculine, professional, and smells good overall, this is for you. I do see this being a compliment getter. I've worn this a couple times, and I did get compliments. If you're looking for that cheap compliment getter, For the evenings, this is it. If you frequent Ross or any other rack stores, this one is popping up. I suggest you get your nose on it. I'm starting to regret not buying the other one. I think it was Regatta. Who knows, it may still be there. Sometimes if you snooze, you lose. If you didn't pick up that Starwalker Extreme from Ross, it's tough to find now. So if you see this, pick it up and try it. You may enjoy it. I did see Regatta on FragranceNet for about $28. I didn't see Riviera on FragranceNet yet, but it may pop up on all the fragrance discount sites. In conclusion, I'm pleasantly surprised. I'm glad I picked this one up. If you like any of the fragrances that I mentioned that this fragrance reminds me of, I think you'll enjoy this fragrance. It's not a clone of any of them, but I think it picks and borrows notes from all of these to come up with its own blend and has a very nice smelling fragrance. Great bang for your buck. A great cheapie. A hidden gem so far. Masculine, seductive, sweet, spicy, smoky. It has it all. Let me know in the comments if you tried any other Façonnable fragrances or Façonnable, whatever the pronunciation may be. Thanks again for stopping by. Until next time, enjoy your fragrances.